The Taliban, meanwhile, released a propaganda picture which appears to mock the US Army and its victory in World War II. The picture on the right of your screen is the famous image of US troops captured on the island of Iwo Jima in 1945. In the image, six US soldiers can be seen hoisting the stars and stripes during the bloody battle against the Japanese army. Now, the image on the left of your screen has been released by the Taliban. It shows fighters hoisting the Taliban flag, allegedly replicating the famous Iwo Jima picture. The fighters in this picture are from Taliban's Badri 313 special unit. Across most of Afghanistan, Taliban fighters are usually seen dressed in their traditional attire. Over the years, Taliban members have been using AK-47 guns and Soviet-made weapons. However, the situation on the ground has evolved in the recent past. The Taliban special forces, like the Badri 313, have been seen dressed in full tactical gear and camouflage instead of the traditional white Afghan attire. Troops of the Badri 313 have been seen on the streets of Kabul. They carry American arms and ammunition. Some can be seen with advanced tactical gear, including night vision goggles. They carry M4 rifles and travel in Humvees. Such advanced weaponry is believed to have contributed towards the Taliban's rapid territorial gains in Afghanistan. In fact, analysts believe the Taliban secured loads of US-made weapons during the recent offensive. The Taliban acquired these weapons from defeated Afghan government troops as they retreated towards the capital in front of a Taliban blitzkrieg. Ian Bremmer, the president of the Eurasia Group and author, tweeted a picture of the Taliban fighters in US-made gear. Between 2002 and 2017, United States of America gave the Afghan forces nearly $28 billion worth of advanced weapons. Some of these weapons have been captured by the Taliban, including armored vehicles, advanced attack helicopters, drones, as well as guns. The situation is so bad that the US government has even admitted it. Washington agrees that U.S.-made weaponry has been acquired by the Taliban. White House National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan recently admitted, I'm quoting, "We don't have a complete picture, obviously, of where every article of defense material has gone. But certainly a fair amount of it has fallen into the hands of the Taliban. And obviously, we don't have a sense that they are going to readily hand it over to us at the airport." We are now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.